Daniel refused. You know, he could have been bitter about being torn away from his parents. He could have been bitter about losing all of his friends and, you know, his social, you know, connectedness back in Jerusalem. He could have been angry with God. But somehow, in the midst of great turmoil, Daniel found the grace to keep his heart soft, to refuse to get embittered, refuse to be offended at God. It's like, it's almost like Daniel, he had all the voices saying, you know, God has abandoned you. Man, if you think God is for you, then why would you have been ripped away? Or why were your parents, you know, he saw his loved ones die at the hand of King Nebuchadnezzar. It's almost like Daniel had all these voices around his head. God abandoned you. He's not for you. You know, why? What use is it in serving God? Daniel hardened his heart to those voices. And he said, you know what? There may be some things going on around me that I don't understand, that I don't have explanations for, but I am going to refuse to allow the difficulty in my life to get a belief in my mind that God is against me or God has abandoned me. Come on, we got some hands clapping.